maybe can't tweak the camp game a little harder.
Probably would have worked out better.
Yeah. That's all right. He's got next time. He's got next
Simon
time.
Simon Belmont
versus
Lord Almighty. I'm getting all the zoners today.
This is such a polarizing matchup. Because he's going to get him off his feet. Like, right. Lukey's definitely going to get in there eventually.
I think this matchup is all right, literally until what's happening happens. As soon as Fox lands the dash attack, the matchup goes out the window. Fox is just going to win.
But
winner's quarters here at South Carolina Arcadian. Winner makes it into top 8.
I can't believe we're already
winner's side. Winner's side top 8 could be Simon Belmont. We'll see what happens here. But Fox, I saw Lukey playing earlier. He very solid. Very solid they are. That's
combos.
A good right there.
If he can get him back at ledge, Disciple is going to have a... I mean, obviously, that's the best place for the Belmonts to play. Wow. But if he can't land.
Yeah, see?
If he can't land with the scoop. I didn't expect the up smash to be near, but it is quite large.
Yeah, we're going to see yet another matchup of zoner character trying to keep out fast character. But Fox is faster, and I'm not going to say he's more deadly, but he's definitely, like, on you more than Falcon is.
Yeah, definitely 100% on you more than Falcon.
Like, that Fox Vortex is ridiculous. All right, hold on. Trying to get past Holy Water at the ledge.
And I honestly think that was better than if he had done any other get up and messed up, because at least now he's back on stage.
Yeah.
As long as he stays on stage. No! Oh, call
him. He's cool. I like that. He threw the far axe to catch the illusion, but he was a little late. So he threw a short axe right after to catch the normal get up. Or the ledge grab, and just again a little late.
But the
ideas are there.
Yeah, no,
he knows how to cover these options.
Great job catching. Did he just?
Okay.
Now he's covered some space.
All right, axe. Yeah, forced a roll and back air. Give me that stock, and that's actually pretty good. All things considered, only 39% on him.
That's
pretty good.
Which isn't bad.
Yeah, especially for Fox.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll take that.
Because he can build up the rest of it, and these mid percentages are the best spot because they keep him at disadvantage for so long.
Right.
I was just about to say, are we going to see a little bit more Reflector?
Now, see, that's the thing. You would think Fox would be able to do Reflector more, but I don't know.
It completely stops his movement.
The fact that it locks him into place until he literally, like, reflects something, I don't know. I feel like it's not, like, a sustainable strategy to be able to pull out the Reflector against the Belmonts because they have just enough options to make you not want to pick. Not landing right there.
Hard read right there.
Oh, hard punish right here. Almost. Okay. I like the patience. A little bit of light in there. Hit the drill, wait for the tech option, and now you gotta get past Holy Water at the ledge.
Holy Water isn't even water. Doing a great job with the tech chase.
It was water at some point. Oh my god.
You know what kind of call out you have to just immediately up smash with the Belmont? That is the thinnest of hitboxes.
It's so small. I'm actually shocked he got that.
No. Disciple not letting this get any time.
Yeah, no, he saw him get that last, like I said, we're shutting this down right now. Lukey, keep me at the ledge. And this is what I'm talking about. You gotta focus on your ledge trapping. Make sure they are taking as much damage as possible to get back to center. No. This is the highway, and you are the toll meter. That's good.
He
put him at the ledge once and took the whole game off.
And that's what the matchup is. Because when he was at the same thing when it was reversed and Disciple was at the ledge, like, he was holding it. But if he didn't kill him,
he didn't hold it nearly as well as Lukey
did.
No,
he did not.
Not nearly as well.
It's literally like, can you get past it? We both have bad get up options, but mine are like.
There you go. So we're going to see Battlefield 4 Game 2. Characters picks. Running it back. Simon versus Fox. At least pick Richter. Richter looks cooler. I don't like the way Simon looks in this game. They did his model dirty.
His holy water is at least blue.
So, fun fact, that actually changes the attribute.
I know.
Yeah, I was like, why? It's like, yeah, y'all are changing that, but you can't make them cooler. Because these are pretty, like, cool characters. But anyway.
I wish they would have been true clones and had a little bit more difference. He won't.
Oh, bro, 83 right off the rip. 15 seconds in, you're in a big hole if your name is Disciple.
He can't allow that to happen again. But
here's the thing, though. It's Fox. That will happen at some point.
At some point.
You are simply fighting for it to
not matter.
You're delaying it. You're delaying it, basically. But Fox is going to get in. He's going to get his damage. Your jobs are to make sure he takes as much punishment as possible trying to get there, and then when it actually starts happening, just make sure you don't die.
It was even more bold that he went for that forward smash after the upbeat. And I knew it was, like, long, but I was like, bro, it's not that long. Like, it's not going to reach.
God, the thin hitbox is coming out. That F tilt on the, if a DLC character F tilts there, it hits.
Yeah.
Oh man. Poor Belmont. Oh, that was a beautiful reverse up smash. That was great. Super great. He reacted.
He wanted out of the corner. He wanted out of the corner.
For sure,
really
for sure. And Luki knew that. He reacted to the slide, and as soon as the second hit came out, he just turned around and popped the up smash. Okay. So now you're back at the ledge, and Disciple is getting away from the Holy Water Ledge Chops for whatever reason. Up throw just going to get him above, and it's time for Fox to get his damage. It's time.
He a clown.
It's time.
You think he's going to land? You think this could be the end of the stop?
No. He might legit die. He had his jump, but doesn't matter. All right, now he's back at center stage, but you see how much damage he took just to get there?
That took a lot out of him. Trying to call it out with up here, but missing just barely. Ooh, going for that.
Oh, misses the jab. And Disciple gonna miss the slide, but it doesn't matter.
They got those kill throws. A lot of people forget about that, but the Belmont's
got him.
He's so good at blocking these tether recoveries.
Yeah. When you have that lingering nair like Fox had, it's pretty easy to just like go off and intercept that range.
But if he doesn't find a way to recover and he doesn't find a way to keep him at this ledge,
yeah, it's gonna be rough.
It's being pretty rough, and he's getting juggled back and forth.
Reverse utils just to mess with his opposition a little bit. But the Holy Water F smash, 80%. We are back in the game. But
it's not too late.
The way this game is going, you got to think it's only a matter of time before Luki just like gets hot and takes this last stock off of Disciple.
And he's rolled. These rolls are costing him a lot.
Did I just see a jab check? What is going on?
Oh, he's got a jab.
He actually checked the dash. That's crazy. All right, landing with forward there, just a pop-up Disciple. Oh,
smart going for that top platform.
Oh, just barely misses. What is happening up here? They are playing dangerous games.
If he had done down there to up B, that would have killed him.
No, like they were both in danger of dying there. Like it was really crazy. All right. Holy water on the platform. Luki going to be able to air dodge out.
I think he was trying to cover the jump there, and it just barely missed.
Ah, react.
Good option.
React.
I was just going to say, I hope you have a good
react.